Hey there, YouTube. Welcome back to a somewhat of an impromptu video, actually. I normally, if I've done a couple of command figures in between doing another battalion, I normally just peg these guys on to the end of the video, or at least I've been doing that for the last couple of batches I've done. Well, this time, I'm actually, as you can see, my painting desk is actually in painting mode at the moment. I'm actually painting my last battalion of line infantry for the Third Corps project, and I just the sun's just come out. It started off being a really miserable day, and a bit of sun's come out. And I just thought, well, you know what? I'm gonna actually make a video of these two guys on their own while the sun's out, and also to try and make the video of the last battalion of line infantry a little bit shorter. So basically, I did these guys in between finishing my last battalion. I also, of course, tidied up the first battalion of these chaps too, because I know I keep saying it, but as you all know, I've basically already got all the first battalions because of my original Third Corps project, which was to, well, it wasn't was to, but ended up being basically the first battalion of every line infantry regiment, and then of course a sort of amalgamation of the two brigades into kind of one brigade. So of course I was missing not only 2nd and 3rd battalions, but also brigade commanders and division commanders, which is why I also seem to be doing quite a few command figures as I've been going along. Well, I managed to, these are my latest two command figures. You may recognise them from pictures that I've posted up on Facebook, but I thought I'd do a video on them because I actually really like the way these guys came out, and I felt that they kind of needed a video on their own to go into a little bit of extra detail on them. So let's get started. So the first person I'm going to show you is this chap here. This is actually the brigade commander, not brigade commander, sorry, the divisional commander for the 11th, which of course is the final division, which is getting done. The figure is a Perry's figure. I believe the horse he's on is actually belong to Kellerman, because I actually stopped horses. But I think this figure just suits this horse so much. And I was really pleased with how it came out. Basically, this, so I'll give you the blurb on this guy. This guy is General of Division Baron Pierre Berthenzi of the 11th Infantry Division. And I'll try and get you closer look at it. I decided to give him, I wasn't sure what colour horse to give him, so I just kind of just started experimenting, and I ended up giving him a sort of a dark grey horse, which came out really, really nice actually. And of course he's got his he's got quite a posh uniform. He's got like a frock coat rather than a normal sort of jacket. But I decided to make this guy a division general division, because he's it's like, yeah, he's got quite a flashy uniform, but he's only got like the one decoration. So you know, this guy's kind of believable. And again, you know, they had such sort of flexibility with their uniforms that there's nothing to say that this guy has got a lot of money, so therefore he brought himself a superior frock coat rather than a normal uniform jacket. Or, of course, this could just be his dress uniform. You know, there's all sorts of various reasons why he could be dressed like this. But either way, he looks very regal. I've given him the sort of accoutrements of a general of the brigade. So he's got the white feathers, he's got that little bit of gold on his red sash, instead of it being like pure gold. And of course, he's got the red shabrak. So yeah, I was really happy with how this this guy turned out, and definitely a very cool looking figure. But yeah, so that's the general division. Now the second figure I did was, this chap was basically going to end up being the command for my reserve artillery, which I haven't actually got in this room. It's actually still in the other room. But it's basically made up of two batteries of 12 pounders. Now, this particular unit, which I suppose you could kind of call a kind of a, well, I don't think you can call it really a brigade, but it's just called a reserve artillery. It's basically two batteries of 12-pounders, and it's commanded by a captain. Now, this captain's called Captain Violi, and I thought, well, you know, to give a captain a full command base is kind of a little bit too far. I did actually originally have the old warlord figure that came in the Waterloo starter set as the reserve artillery commander. So this chap here, but again, he's really way to a higher rank to represent a captain. So what I came up with in the end is I actually kind of borrowed the chief or the colonel of artillery from Vandamme's staff, who is a chap called, let me just have a look at the base here, Colonel Louis Dugereau. So I thought, you know what, I quite like the look of this chap, looking at his, you know, using his horse as a rest for his telescope. And I've had this artillery figure around for a long time. I actually got him from Mrs. Minnie's when they had their Avon Post, you know, Mrs. Minnie's PCP discount. That's how long I've had him. And he's just been sitting around. So I thought, well, you know what, this guy's Captain Violi and this guy can be the Colonel of Artillery, and I'll put him on that base. So that's how it was kind of born, really. And I think it turned out really cool. It's a good use of the figure. Originally, I was going to have him on Vandamme's command base, because again, he would have looked quite nice on there, but things have changed and I think I've chosen a really good use for him. So my reserve artillery has got like a proper command base, even though it's only a captain actually commanding it, but the colonel of artillery is making a guest appearance on his command stand. Well, that's the end of this a little tiny short video, just to show you those two command figures. I'm actually getting on quite well with my battalion. I should hopefully finish it in a day or two. I'm not quite going as fast on these. I'm kind of as fed up as I am of just painting French infantry. I kind of want to sort of savour the last battalion, so I'm painting them just a little slower rate. Plus I've had a couple of times I've had to go out for a few hours, a couple of times so far this week, and I also have a hospital appointment tomorrow which is going to eat up a couple of hours, so I haven't quite had the sort of normal painting sessions that I would normally do, so I'm probably a little bit probably about a day behind what I'd normally be. So these guys are going to take me sort of 5 days ish to finish rather than the 4 days, because obviously I've done, when I finished these guys, which are pretty close to being finished, the ones off to the side here, I would have finished 14 figures of the battalions, which means I've got one more batch of six and then the command, and then they'll be ready. So I reckon a couple of days the battalion should be ready. That's the end of that. Thanks for everyone who is subscribed and enjoys watching my videos. And I'll catch you all in the next one. Bye-bye.